The origin of the Jersey Devil. Long ago, in the Pine Barrens of southern New Jersey, there lived a woman named Mother Leeds. She was known throughout the town for her beauty and charm. But there was one thing that set her apart from the rest. She was pregnant with her 13th child. One stormy night, a group of teenagers decided to venture into the Pine Barrens, searching for adventure and excitement. They had heard the legends of the Jersey Devil, but they didn't believe it was real. They thought it was just a story meant to scare children. As they made their way deeper into the woods, the rain began to pour down harder, making it difficult to see where they were going. Suddenly, they heard a screeching sound, like nothing they had ever heard before. It was the sound of the Jersey Devil. The teenagers panicked and started to run, but they quickly realized that they were lost in the woods. They had no idea which direction to go, and the Jersey Devil was getting closer and closer. They tried to hide, but it was no use. The creature found them and began to chase them through the woods. They could feel its hot breath on their necks as they ran, their hearts pounding with fear. Just as they thought they were about to meet their doom, they stumbled upon an old abandoned cabin. They quickly ran inside and barricaded the door, hoping to keep the Jersey Devil at bay. But the creature was relentless. It scratched at the door and windows, trying to break in. The teenagers huddled together, trembling with fear, as they heard the screeches of the Jersey Devil outside. The storm raged on all night, and the Jersey Devil continued to torment them, until finally, just as the sun was rising, the creature disappeared into the darkness. The teenagers emerged from the cabin, shaken and traumatized by the experience. They knew now that the legend of the Jersey Devil was real, and that they should never have dared to venture into the Pine Barrens. They left the woods, never to return again, but the memory of their encounter with the Jersey Devil would haunt them for the rest of their lives. Before we go on with the stories, I remind you to like the video and subscribe to support the channel. The Haunted Forest. A group of hikers set out on a beautiful day to explore the Pine Barrens of New Jersey, hoping to enjoy the scenic beauty of the forest. They had heard the rumors about the Jersey Devil, but they brushed them off, thinking it was just a myth. As they walked deeper into the woods, they noticed that the trees seemed to be getting denser and darker, and a sense of unease began to creep over them. Suddenly, they heard a blood-curdling scream that echoed through the forest, sending chills down their spines. At first, they tried to convince themselves that it was just an animal, but the sound was too terrifying to ignore. They quickened their pace, hoping to get out of the woods before it got too late. As they walked, they noticed that the trees seemed to be closing in on them, and the path they were on was becoming more and more twisted and difficult to navigate. The sky above them grew dark, and they realized that they had lost track of time. Just when they were about to turn back, they heard another scream, this time much closer. They turned around to see a creature with wings and a goat-like head staring at them from behind a tree. It was the Jersey Devil. The hikers screamed and ran in the opposite direction, but the creature pursued them, its eyes glowing in the darkness. It was as if the forest itself had come alive to trap them, as they stumbled over roots and rocks, trying to outrun the Jersey Devil. As the night grew darker, they realized that they were lost and had no idea how to get out of the woods. The Jersey Devil was still chasing them, and they could hear its screeches getting closer and closer. Just when they thought they were going to be caught, they stumbled upon an old cabin in the middle of the forest. They quickly ran inside and locked the door behind them, hoping to keep the Jersey Devil at bay. But the creature was relentless. It scratched at the door and windows, trying to break in. The hikers huddled together, trembling with fear, as they heard the screeches of the Jersey Devil outside. They spent the whole night in the cabin, listening to the creature's screams and feeling its presence all around them. When the morning light finally broke through the windows, they cautiously peeked outside, but the Jersey Devil was nowhere to be seen. The hikers emerged from the cabin, shaken and traumatized by the experience. They knew now that the legend of the Jersey Devil was real, and that the Pine Barrens were haunted by a terrifying creature that they should never have dared to confront. They left the woods, never to return again, but the memory of their encounter with the Jersey Devil would haunt them for the rest of their lives. The abandoned house. A group of friends set out to explore the Pine Barrens, seeking adventure and excitement. As they walked deeper into the forest, they came across an old, abandoned house that seemed to be calling out to them. Ignoring the warnings of the locals who told them to stay away, the friends decided to venture inside. As they walked through the creaky door, they noticed the musty smell of decay and a feeling of unease that seemed to emanate from the walls. As they explored the house, they noticed strange markings on the walls and a feeling of being watched. Suddenly, they heard a low growl that seemed to come from nowhere, causing them to freeze in terror. They tried to convince themselves that it was just the wind. But as they continued to explore the house, they noticed that objects seemed to be moving on their own, as if something unseen was following them. As they turned a corner, they saw a figure standing at the end of the hallway. At first, they thought it was just their imagination, but as they got closer, they realized that it was the Jersey Devil. The creature was staring right at them, its eyes glowing in the darkness, and the friends knew they were in grave danger. They tried to run, but the Jersey Devil was too fast, and they soon found themselves cornered in a room with no way out. As the creature closed in on them, the friends huddled together, trembling with fear, and prepared for the worst. Just when they thought it was all over, the Jersey Devil suddenly vanished, leaving behind an eerie silence that was almost as terrifying as the creature's presence. The friends quickly fled the abandoned house, running as fast as they could back to their car. As they drove away, they looked back to see the Jersey Devil watching them from the window, its eyes following them until they were out of sight. From that day forward, the friends never spoke of their encounter with the Jersey Devil again, but the memory of that terrifying night stayed with them forever. They knew that they were lucky to have escaped with their lives and vowed never to venture into the Pine Barrens again. Little did they know, the Jersey Devil had marked them, and its presence would continue to haunt them wherever they went. They would hear strange noises in the night, see shadows moving in the corners of their eyes, and feel a sense of dread that they couldn't explain. Years passed, and the friends went their separate ways, but they all carried the trauma of that night with them. One by one, they began to disappear, and rumors circulated that they had all been taken by the Jersey Devil. No one knew what had become of them, but the locals whispered that they had angered the creature and paid the ultimate price. The abandoned house was never explored again, and the Jersey Devil remained a feared and mysterious presence in the Pine Barrens, waiting for its next victims to cross its path. The Jersey Devil's prey. As the days went on, John's fear of the Jersey Devil grew stronger. He barely slept, always listening for the sound of the creature's screech or the rustle of its wings. Every night he would go out and check on his animals, but it seemed that no matter how hard he tried, he could not protect them from the Jersey Devil's attacks. The other farmers in the area soon began to avoid John, believing that his farm was cursed. They whispered among themselves, speculating on what he had done to draw the Jersey Devil's attention. Despite their whispers, John knew that he was not the only one who had fallen victim to the creature's wrath. Other farmers had reported similar attacks, and some had even disappeared without a trace. One night, John decided to take matters into his own hands. He gathered a group of his most trusted friends, armed them with shotguns and axes, and set out into the Pine Barrens to hunt down the Jersey Devil. As they walked through the forest, they heard strange noises and felt as though they were being watched. The darkness seemed to be closing in on them, and they could barely see the path ahead. Suddenly, they heard the Jersey Devil screech, and they knew that they were getting close. They followed the sound to a clearing, where they saw the creature perched on a tree, its eyes fixed on them. John and his friends took aim and fired, but the Jersey Devil was too quick. It swooped down on them, its sharp claws tearing through their flesh. As they lay dying on the ground, John realized too late that the Jersey Devil was not just a creature of legend, but a force of evil that could not be defeated. He watched in horror as the creature flew away into the night, leaving behind a trail of blood and death. Years later, John's farm remained abandoned, a place where the Jersey Devil had claimed its prey. People would still venture into the Pine Barrens, searching for the creature and the truth behind its legend, but they always returned with stories of fear and horror. For John, the memory of that night haunted him until his dying day. He knew that the Jersey Devil was still out there, lurking in the darkness and waiting for its next victim. The Devil's Curse. Sarah had always been a skeptic when it came to the legend of the Jersey Devil. She had heard the stories growing up, but never believed in the creature's existence. That all changed one fateful night. While driving through the Pine Barrens, Sarah saw something that she couldn't explain. A creature with wings and hooves had darted across the road in front of her car. It was too quick for her to get a good look, but Sarah knew that it wasn't a bird or any other animal she had ever seen before. After that night, Sarah began to experience strange and terrifying events. She would hear strange noises in her home, as if someone was walking around when no one else was there. Doors would slam shut on their own, and objects would move on their own accord. At first, Sarah tried to convince herself that it was all in her head, but the more she tried to ignore the strange occurrences, the worse they became. She began to feel as though she was being watched. and her anxiety levels skyrocketed. One night, Sarah woke up to find the Jersey Devil standing at the foot of her bed. Its eyes glowed red in the darkness, and its wings cast a shadow on the walls. Sarah froze in terror, unable to move or scream. After what felt like hours, the creature vanished into thin air, leaving Sarah trembling and alone in her room. From that night on, the strange events only intensified, and Sarah knew that she was cursed. No matter how hard she tried to ignore the Jersey Devil's presence, it was always there, lurking in the shadows and watching her every move. It seemed as though the creature was determined to torment her for the rest of her life. Sarah tried to seek help from experts in the paranormal, but no one could offer her any relief. She was trapped in the devil's curse, and there seemed to be no way out. In the end, Sarah's sanity began to slip away, and she retreated into a world of darkness and fear. The Jersey Devil had claimed another victim, and Sarah's fate was sealed forevermore. Thanks for tuning into our scary story today. Don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to our channel for more spooky tales like this one. Until next time, stay safe and keep your lights on at night.